रहे हैं। देखो ट्रांसपोर्टेशन प्रॉब्लम, फर्स्ट लेट अस सी अबाउट इट्स इंट्रोडक्शन। इन आवर डे टू डे लाइफ वी नीड टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट सेवरल गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज फ्रॉम वन प्लेस विच इज कॉल्ड ओरिजिन और सोर्स और सप्लाई सेंटर टू अनदर प्लेस। अनदर प्लेस मीन्स डेस्टिनेशन और डिमांड सेंटर। इन दिस प्रॉब्लम वी नीड टू फाइंड द रूट फॉर सप्लाई ऑफ गुड्स और सर्विसेज इन ऑर्डर टू मैक्सिमाइज प्रॉफिट और मिनिमाइज द कॉस्ट। वेदर इट बी मॉनिटरी और मैन पावर एक्सेट्रा। इन एडवांस वी नो द कैपेसिटीज ऑफ ओरिजिन एंड द डेस्टिनेशन। मतलब क्या हुआ इसका कि एक जगह से दूसरी जगह हमें कुछ सामान पहुंचाना है या सर्विस देनी है तो ये हमको करने का काम है ट्रांसपोर्टेशन प्रॉब्लम में, ठीक। और हमको वो रूट निकालना है कि जिस रूट से मिनिमम कॉस्ट में या मैक्सिमम प्रॉफिट में या मिनिमम मैन पावर में हमारा ये काम हो जाए या मिनिमम टाइम में मेरा ये काम हो जाए। इट इज आवर मेन पर्पस। और हमको ओरिजिन और डेस्टिनेशन पे क्या कैपेसिटी है ये हमें पता है एडवांस। नाउ सी द मैथमेटिकल मॉडल ऑफ ए ट्रांसपोर्टेशन प्रॉब्लम। सी इन फर्स्ट रो देर आर डेस्टिनेशंस D1, D2, D3, सो ऑन DN एंड इन द फर्स्ट कॉलम देर आर सोर्सेज S1, S2, सो ऑन SM। द सोर्सेज फ्रॉम दिस सोर्स टू वेरियस डेस्टिनेशंस वी नीड टू सप्लाई the goods and services. This is our supply AI, A1, A2, so on AM. This is our available at S1. Similarly, this is our demand B1 at D1 destination. Okay. Let us go to the next page. We have M sources, S1, S2, so on, SM, first column, and N destinations, D1, D2, so on, DN, in the first row. Sources have AI, I is equal to 1, to so on, M, units of supply or capacity, and destinations have BJ, J is equal to so on, N, units of demand or requirement. BJ means J, B1, B2, so on, BN, the lowest row. And AI, IA1, A2, so on, AM, the last column. CIJ is equal to cost of shifting one unit of goods from I to J. And XIJ is equal to number of units shifted from source I to destination J. Go back. This is our CII, CI, C11, C12, so on, C1N, cost of transportation from S1 to D1, from S1 source to D1 destination. C12 cost of transporting from S1 source to D2 destination and so on. And XII units transported from S1 to D1, X11, X12 unit transported from X1 to D2 and so on. So we need to find the schedule so as to minimize the total transportation cost with the conditions of demand and supply restrictions. There are two restrictions. The first restriction is at the last column, restriction of supply, and the second restriction is at the lowest row, the restriction of demand. Mathematically, we can write this transportation problem as minimize Z is equal to summation I is varying from 1 to M, second summation J is varying from 1 to N, Cij, Xij. So this is the Cij, Xij is the cost incurred in transporting Xij unit from ith source to jth destination. Subject to the constraints, summation J is equal to 1 to N, Xij is equal to Ai, means summation of ith rows number of units is AI, and summation I is going to an XIJ, summation of jth column demand is BJ. So this is our AI and this is our BJ. J is varying from 1 to N and I is varying from 1 to M. And the last Xij is greater than or equal to for all I and j, since Xij is unit transported from ith source to jth destination, so it will be always greater than or equal to zero. It can never be negative. Our claim is that a necessary and sufficient condition for a feasible solution, we need to find a feasible solution. For a feasible solution to the transportation problem is that total supply is equal to total demand. When total supply and total demand are fulfilled, then we get a feasible solution. That is, summation I is equal to 1 to m ai, this is our total supply. This is equal to summation j is 1 to n bj, this is our total demand. Means total demand is fulfilled by the total supply, then we get the feasible solution. This is our necessary and sufficient condition. Let us see its proof. Solution, first necessary part. Let us assume that the given transportation problem has a feasible solution. It is our assumption that the transportation problem has feasible solution. Then we have summation j is equal to xij is equal to ai, or it implies that summation I is equal to 1 to m, summation j is equal to 1 to n, xij is equal to summation I is equal to m ai, imply one more summation both sides here, or summation I is equal to 1 ai is equal to summation j is equal to 1 to n and summation I is equal to 1 to m xij, revert these two summation signs. So this can be written as summation j is equal to 1 bj. It means summation I is equal to m ai is equal to summation j is equal to 1 to n bj. So the necessary part is proved. If there exists feasible solution, then this condition is fulfilled. Second, sufficient part. Let us assume that summation I is equal to 1 to m ai is equal to summation j is equal to 1 to n bj. This is equal to k. Suppose this is equal to k. This is our given, and we need to show that the solution is feasible. If there exists a number lambda I not equal to zero, such that xij can be written as lambda I times bj for all I and j, then we have summation j is equal to 1 to n xij is equal to summation j is equal to 1 to n xij. Xij is lambda I bj. Substitute here. This lambda I is constant for this summation, so take it out. So this is equal to lambda I, summation j is equal to 1 to n bj. So this is equal to lambda I into k, where k is this one. From equation 1, summation j is equal to 1 bj is substituted by k. So it is lambda I into k. It implies that lambda I is equal to 1 upon k, summation j is equal to 1 xij divided by k here. So this is equal to 1 upon k into ai. This is our ai. See the equation 1. This is our ai. Next, thus xij is equal to lambda I times bj, it is our assumption. So it is equal to 1 upon k ai into 1 upon k ai, this lambda I into bj. Your xij will be ai bj by k, which is greater than or equal to 0. Since this ai is greater than or equal to 0, this bj is greater than or equal to 0 for all I and j, so xij will be greater than or equal to 0. This is our feasibility condition, that xij should be greater than or equal to 0. So in the sufficient part, we have assumed that these two summations are equal, then the given problem will be feasible, and thus a feasible solution exists since xij is greater than or equal to 0. So this theorem is proved that a necessary and sufficient condition for a feasible solution to the transportation problem is total supply equal to total demand. That is, I is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to n ai is equal to summation j is equal to 1 to n bj. This is our transportation table. It is very easy to understand this. CII, the upper left corner, on the upper left corner, we used to write the cost incurred in transporting from S1 to D1, or from S1 to D2 here, and from S1 to DN here. And here in second row, S2 to D1, C21, S2 to D2, C22, and so on, S2 to DN, C21. And the total of this is AI, the total of this is A2, and so on. and in SM, SM to D1 is CM1, SM to D2 CM2, and so on, SM to DN, CMN, this is M. And this X11 is number of units transported from S1 to D1, X12 from S1 to D2, and so on, X1N from S1 to DN. In S2, X21 is number of units transported from S2 to D1, X22 from S2 to D2, and X2N from S2 to DN, and so on. This XM1 is number of units transported from S1 SM to D1, in XM2 means SM2 D2, and so on. XMN is SM2 DN. The total vertical sum is X11 plus X21, so on. XM1 is D1, and horizontal sum is X11 plus X12 plus 1 plus X1N is A1. It is actually and also A1 plus A2 plus 1 AM, it should be equal to B1 plus B2 plus 1 BN for the existence of a feasible solution. So I think it is all clear, the transportation problem. And if you have any difficulty, raise your hand and ask me your question.